Let's rock and roll. Face the flags. Come here. Get that. Get it. Money up. Come on, huh? Get up.
Greetings, sir.
Grace, my spots go way out there. I did. Stop engaging it.
Here you go.
Greetings, sir.
Hi, Lexi. Hi, Elijah.
Or it might be more cool to say face the boat on, but you know. Okay. So this is a color belt one, right? Where are the color belt?
Like I said though, at about 6:30, 6:40, we'll probably have some middle reds joining online or in person.
All right. So we will skip the chill tone and color tone portion of our program for now. We have this Marilyn doing the lower belt. Oh, did that happen today? I meant to go online.
I have no idea. I don't know.
All right. Well, I don't know. So we don't really usually hit children, eat them in something in this class. We can't.
Well, I'll tell you, it might benefit Mr. Krishka, who's supposed to be testing.
Yeah.
In May, if he remembers to bring his gateway review sheet in.
May of 2024, right? Right. Okay. All right. Well, let's do those real quick. We'll just blow through those as a warm up. To me, I have a different definition of a warm up, and that's just doing anything that we do next. Don't start at full power, full speed. No big deal. You know. Yeah, I won't be able to. All right. Let's talk about home line, please, because I'm getting people across the floor. All right, so three. Take a good job.
Take a good job.
Brush your hands. Step out.
So, Lexi, you won't know this form, and that's okay. Just follow along to warm up.
Good. Okay, so black belts. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that you don't need help with memorizing this puppy, because you already have it. Big limb, I'm going out on right now. Perhaps it's a good fact. Whenever I do a lower belt form, even when I'm demonstrating two belts, I am thinking of eight things to do. Just now, I was thinking snap. So I was working to get everything I could to snap as best. Sometimes I'll think about extension. So whether it's extension with function, really fully extending this puppy, or it's, extension with a kick or whatever. Sometimes it'll be about speed. Sometimes it'll be about the chamber. So I suggest the black belt. That might be a good focus while you're moving. Certainly, don't just follow along like you have for 5, 6, 7, 8, 22 years. Use that time specifically. All right, so, we're not ever going to probably, unless I can't ask you, to do take a Gilgen, take a Dijon, or something like that. But there's nothing like the present to start getting familiar with. Same thing, Lexi. I think Lexi's online. Hi, Lexi. Hi, Mr. Polant. Just follow along and just get familiar with them, but it's not anything we're ever going to ask you yet. Okay. Next. low block. Next, just punch. You punch. Hey, up, just punch. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. So, any front kick that you do, especially those in the back, okay? You had a low block, and then it's, make sure you bring that knee up very powerfully and end it very powerfully. So, up, and then take this, do the thing. And then up, really overemphasize the chamber, because that's very much what people struggle with, getting those chambers. All right, let's keep going. Three. There you go. Sanka.
Sanka.
Come on. Make sure you pull back on that opposite arm. Three. Watch it. Yes. Now get that chamber arm up and tight. Get to your side. Ah, come on. Three. One too much. Left, right. Pull that arm back into position. Ah. Nice and chop. Three. Now, from here, we're going to cross our arms. Blah! Ha! Sit down. Good. Bend that elbow. Open a punch. Good. Set. Turn neck and block. Neck. Open a punch. Ha! I say the form block. Good. Spin around the world. Set. Spin fast. Pull my heart. Neck. Pass on. Yes. Kick and punch. Inline, low block punch, good, low block punch, set, kick, low block punch, Mr. Crawford did it, because Mr. Crawford did it, mad, kick, low block punch, yeah, yeah,
we already know it's Mr. Crawford's fault anyway,
it's Mr. Crawford, everything's Mr. Crawford, don't change what you were about to do, you never know if they're going to be ready, all right, so this is what I want you to practice. Okay, so we got here. I want you as fast as you can. Spin fast, and then lock it right in. No gooing, no anything. And then turn the other side as fast as you can. And lock it in. No adjustments. You get what you get. Okay, so you're going to start with right forward leg, right forward stance, left outside inside forearm block. And then you're going to spin. Do it on your own.
All right, did you guys get that at home? What you're going to practice?
How fast can you
So you want to spin all the way around to a low block as fast as you can and lock it in place. Lexi, this is a good drill for you to do anyways because it works on your balance. Okay? Go ahead.
All right, come on. So you're here. You're here. And avoid lifting while you spin. That destabilizes you. I will turn from my core, my waist, right from here. Just spin. And turn as fast as I can. Up, down, slow you down. Waist in motion. Just spin. Go. Oh, that was better, Miss. Faster, faster. If you stagger, good. That means you're working on it. Oh, you turned way too slow on that other side, Miss Pam.
Sir.
Speed, speed.
Yes, sir.
Get around there quick. I don't really care so much about the 1-2 punch. Spin over. That's it. Don't step too wide in an effort to stay balanced. Yep. Oh. Like that video you sure. Thanks. Okay, so there's a great drill to do at home. I'm going to leave the Poomse on for a moment. There's another good drill for us. So everybody being a left guard stance, and what I want you to do, you're going to take your back leg, and you're going to transfer to your ball of your foot, and you're going to spin around. Oh, boy, that was awful. Spin around and down. Spin. Wow, that was awful, too. I was just doing this. Just spin. Hey. Stay in the ball of your foot. Ready? Spin hard and back. Hard and back. Then you get all the way down and lock it, but get all the way there.
That's hard to spin it.
Yeah. Wait for the next
one. It sucks.
The kids won't spin on the ball. So he's pushing. Really? All right. So, because I don't want to take a lot of time with this, that's a great drill. When you can do that, not stagger, that's your ranking. Well, stagger. Yeah, let's go the other way. So, we're still in the left guard, everybody. This time, we're going to spin the other way and come all the way around. Here, spin. And that's your spin. Motion. Try that. Spin back. You're spinning, and then you're adjusting that foot forward. Stay in the ball of that foot. No, don't adjust. That foot stays where it is, and then the other one goes. Now, don't go down the line. The lines are too tricky. Yeah. All right, come on. So I'm just giving you, there's a couple of drills to do at home. Drill them a ton. Do it until you can spin all the way around and lock. And then the round kick and the spin hook kick and every other technique that comes out of that motion will be just fine. Okay, back to the Poomse genre. So, really? So,
you don't do tennis, I do that.
No, I know. Tego Saja? Let's both do it a couple times. You go ahead and do a couple, I'll do it.
Come in. Tego Saja?
Saja.
Do it again. Come on. Step here. Step. Right side spin. Next. Here. Blocking shot. Boom. Kick punch. Make sure you pivot all the way over. Set. One. Two. Twin.
Okay, stop. Front toes. Yep. Okay, now.
All right. Spin around inside block. Come on.
Fast.
Boom. Kick. Bring it back.
Fast.
Other arm. Cut. Net. Cross it. Black and cut. Close. Net. Hold on. Hold on. Have your left foot forward a little bit more. Other side. Come on.
You got anything that happened?
Oh, go ahead. I wasn't really watching that much.
So, as a general comment, you all go glide into position. And then when I yell at you and you move suddenly, I know why you glide. If you move fast and then you stagger, you don't want to stagger. But don't not stagger. Go hard, go fast, in tight, stagger until you don't. But don't work to get it right because you're afraid of looking like you got it wrong. Who cares? The goal is to get it right. So, you know, even this, you're here, you're blocked, right? Now, turn hard and fast. And everything's fast. Everything's fast. I was watching you guys, especially this one. It's like gliding. It shouldn't be. So that leads into the next thing. I think somehow you feel it.
I don't know if you want to.
How do I explain it? This should trembling stuff. Remember that? When I was being taught to be an international referee, that was the only. Well, that was the requirement for somebody to get a point. What's that?
What was the phrase?
Trembling shot.
Trembling shot. Meaning that if I round kick you and you just stand there, it could be a beautiful round kick. It could be a solid round kick. It could be a loud whacking round. I'd still get no point. I had to stagger you. That was the Taekwondo thing. I had to stagger you. Turn back. I had to stagger you. Fortunately, it's not that way so much anymore. Oh, right. Not usually. What's that?
Imagine the Olympics don't really see much.
Oh, no.
Modern Olympics are terrible.
No. They dance now. What's up? It's all electronic, and as long as you know where to hit, you get a point for nothing. In Grandmaster Lee told me about in the early days of Taekwondo and Pungsudo in Korea, they would make hogus, chest protectors, with bamboo slats. And they would hit each other so hard, they would crack the bamboo. You know how hard it is to crack bamboo? That's how hard they hit each other. So trembling shock was a thing. I bring all that up because every move you do, you have trembling shock. I was watching this first move. All right. So we have one, two. And it kills me. Here, you got to snap it in your hips. You do a thing and snap it. Go ahead, show us your hips. You do it. So from here, it's one. And there's that. Trembling shot. And here, every move has a little micro hip job. A little, yeah, kind of. Everything you do should have that. Very much leaves, though. So you do a form once, right? You should be exhausted and not be able to do another one. You got exhausted a lot. Did you ever hear him say that? It's a very standard thing. You had to, everything had to just. Yes, ma'am.
So with that intensity, how do you remain relaxed? Breathing.
Because you have intense momentarily. So, and I'm relaxed. It's only in the instant of the delivery that you have to. Bruce Lee would say the same thing. You relax, he said. For the moment, then you're up. I had a problem with that. Once I would generate that much power and energy, I would stay there. I'd stay clenched. He'd walk over and smack me. Even Grandmaster Wong was a big problem. He thinks I stayed there too long. Anyway, so let's do it again. But this time, you can't do it anymore. Follow my supposed to go again, but take every motion.
Sergeant. That's it. Great. Yes, kick punch. There we go. Side. Side. Turn your butt.
Fast and hard.
Kick.
Extend your hard.
Other arm is proper.
Other arm. Pull it fast.
Set.
Turn hard.
Net.
Kick. Get reach.
Block. To the back. Block and chop. Hana. Hold it in hard. Set. Net. Forward stance in the back. Hana.
So I was inspired by watching Master Puska.
Well, somebody was.
Absolutely inspired. And I think I know a piece of why y'all are struggling with the little thing. Because when he does it, it settles him into the stance. When you guys do it, you do it, and then you stagger. Rather than that energy, that motion, that kick drive, that everything grounding you, that's the word I wanted, grounding you to the mat and locking in. And this is all going to end up in the exact right. See, I hurt my toe right now because my foot had to go there. The freaking mat is there. I think I broke my toe. But no matter what, it's going in the right place. It just is. It's going there because that's where it's got to go. So as you punch, it should settle you and lock you into the stance. Not just be in the stance, but lock you into the stance. Like a snap, locking into place. I'm trying to think of an analogy. So take a minute. You take a side jump on your own. Macy, follow along, especially if you can. All right. And think about the motion into. Some of you are too high. Some of you don't completely turn that last little bit into the board. You're here. There's not that last little bit of motion to lock it. You should be shunk. Gears locking into, I don't know how to. That's all we got. Give it a shot. On your own. Take your time. Think about locking into your stance. How you guys doing at home? You getting this okay? Lexi, do this. You can do this drill with any other form that you know, or just follow your brother if you want to. Either or, okay? All right, good, good. Back on that arm. That arm has work to do. Pick a sidekick, pick a sidekick. One, two, three, nine, ten, one. This is Pam?
Yes, sir.
Look at me.
I'm sorry?
You're all up here. You're all up
here. I'm kind of up here, sir.
The gear should sink you. Even a walking stick, sink you. Watch him when he does that walking. I'll have to do it for you, man.
Yes, sir.
It settles him. Don't raise you to show up.
Yes, sir.
It settles you into the place. It grounds you. This, there's that. See, when I turn as far as I'm supposed to, I feel it pulling on me. I feel it, which is why most people don't go there. They go there because that's more comfortable. Can you do that walking thing and you do it because you would be?
Oh,
yeah. Okay. See how he, did you see it? We can watch his hips and watch his feet lock into it. And he's grounded. He's not up here. There's no piece of him that's up. He's grounded. There's no piece of him. That's up here. He pulls in, boom, and wham, silent. You will not get this today, but I'll yell at you anyway. So, well, and that's going to take time. And you know what's really good for that? IQ. The 5 years I spent, 6 years of my teaching IQ, really taught me about being grounded.
I have tried to.
I still would like to find him.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, he moves. See, he's teaching. I hope that he is. But he also wished that he really came down to the angle to the hips, stressed. He had this little ditty. That was perfect. Too close to be stable. So you gotta be open more. Say that's it. Take that first 50 into the ground. See, when you're this, you can't. You gotta be bigger. I'm always telling you, your back stance is gonna be that perfect. That's perfect.
Right.
Well, because when you use your hand, you know, when you're on your piano, all right. Let's go on to Ojung very quickly. All right, because we're running out of time. I'm not going to spend too much time on Ojung or Yeokjung, but a couple of key pieces, I'm sure. So, to me, Tempo Ojung.
Tempo Ojung.
Turn level count. Look big. Remember, feet are shoulder width apart, pointing straight ahead. Set. Net. Hammer fist. Hana. Block. Block. Put. Kick. Back fist. Block. Set. Kick. Back fist. Block. Step. Back fist. Kia.
Oh, yeah.
Good. Spin around. There was that spin again, right? Just go back to the back fist for a second. So we're in the back fist, right foot forward. Same thing as before. Spin fast. Right hand block. Set elbow. You're right there, Savannah. Hold on. Right hand block. Set elbow. Next. To the back. Low block. Punch. Low block. Sorry. Low block. Low block. Come back here for a second. Right forward, same. Don't just turn and put this on there. Right? From here, from here in, set your hip. Boom. One of that side. Okay. Give it. Extend all the way out. Elbow. Here we go. Explode all the way up. Set. Back, explode. Time. One, two.
Don't
block me. One.
Three.
Yeah.
You're going to get fooled. You should take the band.
Really?
All right, so I'm watching you all do the back half of the biggest load now. There's it here, but I can feel it. Okay. And kick, and drop, and then you lunge. And it really should be, and that stays right there. And then I lean, push. Don't, you know how much work it is to pick this thing up and then start off? Yeah, you know, it's awful. So we kick, boom, and that knee stays spatially right there. Now, if you have to drop it a little when you hit the lung, but work to the point where, you know, that back leg is supposed to do all the work. All right, turn around. Left leg in front, left outside is just one block. Left leg in front. Go ahead, right kick, keep the knee up, and lunge. All right, do it a couple of times. Feel it. What are you feeling with that knee? What's going on? Is it staying where it belongs? Are you flinging the leg, the right leg, to help you cover distance? Are you using that as ballast? Are you using that as weight to pull on you? Uh-oh, somebody's coming in.
Stacy's coming online. That means we have Miss Leone is starting class. Yay! Colby, get your mom out there. I see Stacy.
Yay!
Hi, Stacy.
Let's go. Yay!
Hi, Gabriel. How are you? Why do I see BF? What is that? BF Smurf?
It's a fox.
B. Jay Smurf. I don't get it. Okay. Who's that? Oh, hi there.
It's me. It was when I was on a meet with some girlfriends. I'm so excited.
Oh, yes. Sure. Smurf.
I tried to change the name.
There it is. Love everything about it. All right, guys. We'll get you. Hold on. All right.
Yes, as in BJ's Warehouse wholesale.
Never let Miss Falling look back down. Her name from now on is Smurf. Put on the camera. Hi, sir, Adam.
Your smart filter, sir.
What's that?
Smart filter, please.
That's it. Right. Come on in. They should put the child, you're a red belt. Your belt should not be going up and down. You have to untie it, retie it, couple of like so. Yeah. So kids, when their belt is tied on, it's doing this, they fix it by going sideways. Then they let go and it goes going. Okay, so since we've got some bodies coming in, we'll shift off in the children room. Now, for you all that have been listening to me drone on, there's two things that you guys can work on. Snapping it like children. You know, the way I do children, okay? From here, one, and you lock everything. It just, I didn't. There's that little, and it all from here. And right there. And it locks into place. You settle down. Too many people are up here. Settle down. The new guys, while we're doing baby children, y'all should practice the snapping in and keeping knees where they belong, all that kind of stuff, and turning quickly into position. While the rest of these guys, it's really about memorizing the form. Okay? Now you guys should not be memorizing the form. You guys should be perfecting them. Okay? Memorization is all done. It's all gone. You're still wasting time on that. You need to hit hooks. Make some flashcards. Great drill. Make flashcards of every technique in a form and throw them down the stairs. And take them up and have to put them back in order. That means please talk slower. I have no idea what you're saying. I learned that one because I went to Korea and I really need people to slow down. Hello, Mr. Balling. Hello, Miss Lexi. Hello, Mr. Colby. Oh, excuse me, Stacy. I guess we're using Miss Stacy. Do you want me to start? Do you want to start? So, upper belts, it's about all those pieces. You and Miss Lexi and Mr. Colby, this is about not trying to get it right, just trying to memorize it. That is a horrible way to do that. It should really be doing chunks. No, as long as they do the other pieces. I'll go write a note right now. Make sure that I do.
Okay, everyone. So, Savannah, Colby, Curtis, Lexi, just follow along as best you can. This is a good way. You guys are going to be doing this a lot for the next 6 months. To me. Stay with children. Turn to your left. Come on. Called the tiger stand. So have your left leg bent. That's it. Kind of sitting down a little bit. Now with your right leg, the one that you're standing on mostly, boom, kick, and then block. That's it. Good. Now turn to the other side. Same thing. Palm block. Touch. Good. Shoot your hands anterior, Savannah. And keep your leg. Good. Now kick, and then block. Good. Now reach way up behind you. Step to the front. Twin that hand block low. Reach way up behind you, turn that hand block low again to the front. Now towards your left side, palm block. Your other hand is under your elbow. Circle back this. Now you're gonna do the other side. Palm block, circle back this. Good. Now take your right hand, make a fist, put it in your left hand. Feet are touching and you're going to push out. You should be able to see right over your hands. All right. Drop your left arm, and your right arm is up. Left step forward. One and two. That's it. Good. Now, as you step forward, I want you guys to switch your arms. Step forward, switch your arms, and then it's going to be one and two. That's it. Good. That's a tough move. That's our hardest part of this form. Cross your hands right in front of you. Keep your front foot where it is. Spin all the way around. Wedge block. Okay. Hands are blocking. Open up. Knee strike. Stepping forward. Two punches right to the belly. Then step back. Crossing blocks down. Hands are making an X shape. Cross your hands in front of your chest. Spin around. Block. It's called a wedge block. It looks like this. Like a wedge of cheese. Open. Knee strike. Step. Double upset punch right to the belly. Step back. Crossing blocks down. Good. That's it. Now to the back of the room. Really hard. Back fist. Okay, you're standing up nice and straight, and you're doing a back fist to the back. With your back leg, your right leg, you're going to swing up, you're going to keep your hand, and then you're going to elbow as you land. Go. That's it. You're in a side stance here. Side stance. Pull your right hand and leg back on it. Back fist. Now kicking your left leg, and then elbow straight. Good. Now from there, left hand, block to the back, right hand with a back stance. We're going to step, punch, and here. Back stance here. And pull. Jump. All right. Ooh, we have somebody else coming in. So again, the recording of this, guys, will be on our YouTube channel by the end of the week. So you can also follow along that way too. All right, let's do it again. To be. Take a chill, John. Turn to your left, pump up. Come on. Good. Now, right leg. Kick and bring it back. Block. Good. Now on this side, turn to your right, pump up. Start. Okay, bring it back and block. Good. Reach up way back behind you. Step forward. Twin knife hand block to the front. We're going down low. Stepping forward again. Twin knife hand block. Good. Now to your left side. Palm block. Hand under your elbow. Circle. Back fist. Switch your hands for me. Sit back. No, your legs are good. Turn to the other side now. Palm block, circle, back fist. Right fist into your left hand. Feet are touching. Good. Now from here, drop your left arm down. Stepping forward. One, two. Good. Now, as you take a right step forward, I want you to switch your arms. And then again, one, two. That's it. Good. Now, cross your hands in front of your chest. Keep your front foot where it is. Spin all the way around. Wedge block. Open your hands. Knee strike. Stepping. Double punch to the belly. Step back. Crossing block. Good. This is a forward stance here. Cross your hands in front of your chest again. Spin back around. Wedge block. Good. Open your hands. Knee strike. Step. Double upset punch. Stepping back. Crossing block down. Now, pull in really hard. Back fist to the back of the room. Okay, again, with your right leg, you're going to do a crescent kick right into your hand. And then elbow. You should be in a side stance right here. Pull back hard, back fist. Open your hand, crescent. Elbow. Now, to the back of the room. Knife hand block, back stance. Set, punch, here. And this is a back stance here. So your front toes should be going to the back of the room where your punch is. Your back toes should be pointing straight towards the wall where your body's facing. And pull. Sure. Very good. So for
Lexi, Colby, Curtis, and oh dear man, it's messing me up, dear. You're a boat on now. Wow. And Savannah. The first thing I want you guys to practice is the first move. So what you're gonna do right from here, you have to turn to your left side and you have to squat down. You have to kind of crouch down a little bit. Your front leg is gonna be bent, okay? It's your front leg that's bent. Your back leg should be nice and solid, most of your weight on your back leg, all right? And then you're blocking across your body.
Hi, Mistia. Mr. Bowling, are you working with us? You're just watching us. Guys, I know this is very hard to learn online. We'll get you all an email sent out shortly that will help with this. But this is hard. I get it. Just keep following along as best as you can.
All right. One more time through. And then that'll be it for the chill jump group. Okay? And we're going to go on to the advanced red belt. To me. Stay with chill jump. Turn to your left. Come on. And now kick and bring it back. Good. Turn the other side. Come on. Set. Net. Kick and walk. Turn that hand to the front. Come on. Turn that hand again. That's it. Now again to your left side. Palm block. Hand under the elbow here. Circle. Breakfast. Other side. Palm block. Hand under the elbow. Circle. Breakfast. Make a right fist inside your left hand. Okay. Drop your left arm down. Step forward. One and two. Good. Now, as you step forward, I want you to switch your arms. One and then two. That's it. Cross hands. Spin all the way around the world. Switch block. Open your hands. Knee strike. Step forward. Two up, double upset punch. Step back. Crossing block. Good. Cross hands. Spin all the way around. Switch block. Open. Knee strike. Twin upset punch. Step back, crossing block. Good. Back fist to the back of the room. Body's facing the back. Open your hand. Press it. Kick. Elbow strike. Nice side stands here, everyone. Pull back hard. Back fist. Open your hand. Press it. Elbow. That's it. Neck hand block to the back. We're in a back stance, so your toes are facing that way. Step punch. Kick. And hold on. Sure. All right. So that's your form, middle red belts. Okay, and that's a good introduction, especially for your first time doing it. So remember to check the YouTube channel, okay? We actually have the first part of that form on the YouTube channel already. And then I will upload the video from this class up to that channel by the end of the week. Okay, guys? So middle red belts, Colby, Curtis, Lexi, you guys are all set. All right. We're going to go on to our advanced red belt form. Thank you for joining. Great job tonight, guys. We'll see you tomorrow in class. Okay. Have a good night. All right, Ms. Dia, we're going to go on to Paul Jung now. And Mr. Plunk, we're going to go to Paul. All right.
I know. Go ahead. I'll work for a minute.
All right, everyone. To me. There you go, Paul Jung. Turn your body, step. Come on. Good. Open up, punch. Turn. Set. Kick. Block. One, two, punch. Next, step punch. Okay, now here we go. Again, turning fast and hard, but you should still lock your stance. Come on. Turn. Crawford. And right arm should be blocking upward. Macy, bring your arm up a little bit. That's it. Good. Now, turn your body into a forward stance to the other side. Nice and slow, 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 slow. Uppercut. Good. Now, step in, step out, block. Good. Turn, twist your body the other direction. That's it. Now, turn. Slow, 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 slow. Uppercut. That's it. Dia, make sure your other hand is by your shoulder here.
So when you go to do the uppercut, your other hand comes to your shoulder. That's it.
All right, from here, turn. Two knife hand block to the front. Open up, punch. Kick. Step back, palm block. Reach up, two knife hand block. Right to your left side. Front leg, kick. Forward stance, punch. Pull it back, palm block. Good. Other side, two knife hand. Front leg kick, step punch, palm block. To the back of the room, double fist block, good fist block. Two kicks, kick. One, two, turn, knife hand block, back stance. From here, you need to shift your foot over into a forward stance, elbow, back fist, punch, go. Other side, knife hand block. Elbow, back fist, punch, Kia. Hold on. Shit. All right. So, Dia, since you're a Bodan and you have the form memorized, we're going to start talking a little details now. All right. Detail number one I want to point out is when, which way should I do? I'm going to do it this way. When you all come from this position, almost everybody, I can't tell if you were doing it, Dia, or you were supposed to. Almost everybody does this. Like you're scooping your hand through water and coming up. That's not what it is. From here, you turn and your hand comes right to your side. And it comes upward like an uppercut. So here, as I turn, I extend this hand outward and this hand comes right against my side, palm down. And then as I settle, okay, slow, boom. And at the last second, everything locks in place. Then other side, right here, turn. Last second, everything locks in place. So it's not scooping downward, it's got to come to your side. Number one. Number two, this is a big one, you see a lot. From the tiger stance to a knife hand block. All right, everyone come here for a second. All right. Front kick, boom. I see this a lot, where the back leg is bent. The heel comes up and your back leg is bent. You need to drive that heel into the ground and lock your back leg, okay? It's a forward stance. Then from here, you don't come up and down, right? You have to push and keep your head at the same level as you come back. That tiger head. So there's a lot happening in there, right? From here, kick. Lunge into that forward stance, locking it in place, and then hopping back into that tiger stance without going up and down, up and down. Yeah. Yeah, okay. You know, I wonder how much of that is left over from Grandmaster Lee, who was, you know, old style Taekwondo with a lot of up and down, up and down. That was the original style. Or he's going to paint another. All right, so let's do that again. Keeping in mind those bits, those two pieces there. All right, Jubi. Hey, apologize. Turn, punch. Punch. Up, set. Block. One, two. Step, punch, net. And now, turn and block. Now, here we go. Punch. Better. That's it. Good. That's it. Yeah, good. Spin. Come on. Put a knife in. Punch. Set. Kick. Step back. Net. Here we go. Here's another piece right there, right? Come on. Kick. Lock your back leg. Good fist in the back. Kick. Good. Now from here, again, turn. Fast and hard. All right, here's another piece, gang. Okay. Let's do this first. I want to watch everybody. Remember, elbow, back fist, punch. Go ahead. Kick. Other side. All right, everyone come to here with the backstand single knife hand. Okay? When you go to do the elbow, first of all, you need to slide your front foot off to the side because you have to open up into a forward stance. Two, when you guys explode into that forward stance, don't waste that energy. That's where you should throw that elbow. However, you don't want to overextend that elbow, and now you've lost your stance and your stability. All right? So from here, as you shift out, elbow, and your body's a little forward stance, back fist, and then punch. And notice that my body has not twisted side to side, but I've had a little bit of hip pop every single time. All right? So again, let's come to here. So from here, as you shift to that forward stance, explode with that elbow, back fist, and then punch. That's it. All right? Practice that part, guys. I want all of you to just practice that part. Okay, because again, Dia, you know the form. So now it's a matter of getting the pieces down. Okay. So remember that piece?
Yeah.
That's what all of us talking about with sinking into your tank, same thing here. As you guys go over, because there's so much force, you got to be careful that you don't shift over, right? So you need to actually use that as a chance to sink down into your tank. And then from there, don't move. Just watch, drop it and lock in.
Thanks. We good?
Yes, sir. We're good.
All right.
Okay, guys, we're going to go ahead and bow out. So, you know, this class is about something that we don't get to often do in class. And it's all of the billions of little details. And if you get it, when you get it, they show up in everything else that you do. And I don't just mean martial arts, I mean, you guys are really learning to pay attention to the micro management of things, really paying attention to you, the environment, and all that. It's so important, so very important. What keeps me up at night? You and I are sure having down with
cats.
What? Cats, yes, cats do keep me up. You and I are driving down the hand and put the grim as long as the hit by. Who else is going to know all of these people? It's on your shoulders, Tom. You have to learn very quickly. No stress there, though.
I mean, she's technically the most senior student.
Really? I love everything.
It's either you or me. I can't remember.
No pressure.
No, but if we both get hit by a truck, then it's
that. Long, I love everything. You know, but nobody taught me this. Grandmaster Lee did this. He did not taught that though. And Grandmaster Wong, he was too busy teaching new forms. Not that he ever had to do the thing. Oh no, he did have to do the thing. But I just learned this stuff from doing it. Experimenting, figuring it out, what works, what does, how do you explain it? Where did you learn? Is that it?
Doing it a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you see, he and I are alike in that we train on our own. We do this. Not anymore, we're old, but I don't know, we used to grapple and spar for hours and hours. Hours. Loved everything about it. All right, let's go. Basic life, please. Come here! Okay, done. Come here. Basic life. Come
here! I'm just going to get it.
We flustered.
Yes, very much.
And it's like, oh!
That's
what's up.
All right. All right, Ms. Dia, have a great night. See you guys tomorrow.
Yeah, but then what happens if you get if you're in that front? You are
right.
Now you probably be better for meeting me here.
Yeah. Okay. All right, wait.